What is going on, everyone? My name is Jeff, and in today's video, we are going to talk about the three stocks to short for February of 2019, guys. So I published the three stocks to buy video yesterday, and of course, every month I come in with the three stocks to short video shortly after that, okay? So just a quick recap of some of the stocks I chose to short in January. We talked about oil companies and mostly focused on BP. Did not get the price movement I was anticipating. We will talk about that a little bit in this video. How that the overall market is starting to trend back up. It does look like we are in a recovery. So obviously a lot of people's strategy is probably going to change. You're probably not going to be doing as much short selling and as many put options now as you have been over the past couple of months. But remember, you know, bull market, bear market, there's stocks always going down, and we will find them and we will short them, okay? We also talked about Spark Energy, guys. Now Spark Energy actually did recover a little bit, but they did hit some high points over the month of January. I did actually complete one short sale on them and got about a 5% gain, and I covered and got out. But if you did listen to the techniques I explained to use for that stock, you could have got a nice short sale on Spark Energy a couple of different times in the month of January. And lastly, we also talked about Cirrus Logic. Of course, I shorted them a lot in October and November. I was a lot more hesitant over the month of January, just simply because the market was recovering, okay? And now let's go get started. All right, so listen up for just a moment. If you are new to the stock market, you are not experienced in short sales, and this is all kind of experimental for you, or even if you are moderately experienced in short sales, let me just encourage you right now, do not try to be shorting any stocks while the market is recovering, okay? Because like I said, you really, really have to be even more cautious, and you have to be more reactive, okay? If you get a small gain, like I said, it's always better. Even if you just make $10 or $20 on a trade, that's better than taking a loss. You want to set your goals even lower than the months previously, okay? Do not be afraid to just don't short sell and don't play put options at all. But anyways, guys, this is probably the most obvious short sale on the market. It is PG&E, ticker symbol PCG. So they've just most recently filed for bankruptcy. As you can see, the stock is down 68% over the past year. So one thing is for sure, it is getting really ugly between the management at PGE and the shareholders. You know, there's even talks that they're gonna try and battle the bankruptcy. Even one of the investment firms have talked about launching a proxy contest in hopes to reverse the bankruptcy. But the bottom line is, guys, this company is in piss poor shape right now. And here in November, when they dipped down so hard and they spiked back up, you know, a lot of that was probably fake news that they want circulating, you know, to kind of give investors false hope. And sadly enough, people still go out there and buy these stocks when they hear that crap, okay? And then as you can see, December came along, January, and then even in the first part of January, while all the stocks were recovering, this stock tanked down even further. And I do see quite a bit of downside even from here. Do your homework on the stock and you will see what I'm talking about. But I think it is a great candidate to keep on your short sale list. Of course, it's very difficult to find shares too short right now, so I would probably go the put options route. Now, the second stock to short, guys, would be AT&T. Okay, now, I know, very well aware, that AT&T was on my list of stocks to buy last month. Like I said, I seen it as a recovery play into the ex-dividend date. But historically, and especially here lately, guys, AT&T is making a habit of missing on earnings. And like I said, guys, this earnings report is absolutely pathetic. Okay, they missed by $510 million. You know, they did beat on EPS, they beat on the top line, but they missed by $510 million of revenue and did not have very good guidance. So right here, guys, I have the one-year chart pulled up on AT&T, and of course, always be aware of the ex-dividend date on AT&T and make sure you're not shorting it on the ex-dividend date, or you will have to pay the dividend payment back to the broker, okay? So always be conscientious of that. Again, if you're not experienced with this type of thing, I would suggest you just stay away from it. But right here at these levels at $29.37, would I want to run out and short it here? Probably not. But as the market recovers, I can see AT&T trading back up to around $30 or $31 again, and that is when I would feel as appropriate time to short them. You know, the stock is down 21% over the past year, and over the past 5 years, it is down 12.41%. So it's disappointing to see their not just their overall performance. You know, a lot of people get talked into holding this stock long term because it pays a great dividend. Where me, I'm from the school of thought, I would rather own Verizon Wireless and I would rather trade AT&T. Like I said, I like to buy it when it's cheap, sell it on the ex-dividend date, and stay away from it on earnings. You know, I'm saying if AT&T gets back to $30, maybe $31, I am calling it a short, guys. And the third and final stock to short, guys, is Overstock.com. Ticker symbol OSTK. Now guys, this stock has seen its market cap getting depleted for well over a year now. You know, right here on the 5-year chart, you will see they had that massive spike up back in January of 2018, and it was all across Wall Street that this was the most obvious short, you know, really on the market. Now, if you would have got shares short at $84, guys, you could see you would have an outstanding gain right now. Of course, the way I short stocks, I would have already covered and moved on by now. And even over the past month, guys, short interest on Overstock has jumped up to nearly 50%. So one out of every two shareholders are holding Overstock.com short. So this is what I would be looking for. Do not go out here and short at $18. What we're gonna be looking for is a short squeeze, okay? Wait till the shorts have overdone it a bit and they're forced to cover and get out, and then some buying pressure will come in. You will see kind of an artificial pop in the stock. You might see it run to $22 or $23. I can't really know exactly when that happens. Just put this stock on your watch list and kind of watch for an unnatural pop in the stock. And that would be the time to come in with a short sale or a set of put options, okay? And even a story like this one too, guys, where it got pushed up 7%. They were talking about bringing a security token platform to their website, and they had plans to use cryptocurrency. The stock shot up roughly 7%. You know, when you look and see, identify some things like that, again, that is probably a good time to think about shorting it. Because the long-termness of the stock, guys, I don't really see the survival of it. And like I said, one out of every two shareholders are holding this stock short. But anyways, guys, that's all I got for today's video. I appreciate you watching. Drop me a comment. Tell me some stocks that you were thinking about shorting for the month of February. Drop a like on this video, and thank you for watching.